This program is brought to you by the winning Camry Crows. Good evening and welcome to the 1998 Crows Club Champion Awards.
The 1997 AFL Coca-Cola Premiership Cup to the Adelaide Crows.
Yes, it's a day of history really for South Australia. Back-to-back flags.
Good evening and welcome to the Football Park Convention Centre. There are the two Premiership trophies, side by side, 1997 and 1998. Welcome to the 1998 Crows Club Championship Awards. Just 9 years ago, yes, it was just 9 years ago, the Adelaide Football Club existed in name only. The administration had just months to create a team from nothing, to take on the powerhouses of the VFL to become the AFL. It was a big job. The powerhouses with lots of tradition. Your clubs like Collingwood, your clubs like Richmond, Essendon, teams that have had supporters for decades, premierships galore, and devoted supporters to carry them through the hard times. Over the next 8 seasons, the fledgling young Crows learned to spread their wings and did it the hard way. They took the knocks and slowly began handing them back. In 93, we had a taste of success, but it was just a taste. Until we reach the present day, not only have we established our right to mix it with the big boys, we are the big boys. Tonight is a night to recognise the players, the guys who put their bodies on the line, so we as Crow supporters and South Australians can stand a little taller. By the end of the night, we'll have a new club champion to join those who have won the prize gold jacket before. Will it be a new face or a previous winner? The club champion is chosen by 5 people. Coach Malcolm Blight, Football Operations Manager John Reid, Assistant Coach Daryl Hart, Specialist Coach Neil Craig, and either Chairman of Selectors Terry Moore or runner Peter Maynard. After each match, they select their best 5 players, the finals included, then give their top 5 a rating out of 10, with any player able to score a maximum of 50 votes in a match. That's how it works. Let's now then take a look at the highlights of rounds 1 to 4.
Little kick forward there by Stevens. Piccioni taken down. Stevens kicked the goal.
Isn't 32 kicks in those hand passes. I look up from reading that and find Adelaide with the ball. What the heck happened is it popped in from Bickley and Ricciuto's got it. Well, kick from about 45. Beautiful effort, marvellous kick, goal.
So in the left forward pocket for the Crows, the boundary throw in. Snapshot there by Caven. That is a goal of the day so far by Peter Caven for Adelaide.
Extra space and smart, off hands behind the opportunist McLeod. Open goal and he's got it.
Corman Allen got a boot to it, it's down towards half quarter. Look at the roaming in the front of the pack by McLeod. Is this number 3 for the Crows? Yes! Costa in turn gets it away and it finishes with McLeod. McLeod bends it back for another one!
The centre square, smack bang in the centre of Football Park. Pittman gets the ball across to the Raging Bull. Here's Ricciuto, dodging and weaving, does well. Still the Pittman back to Smart. They've got the number. Smart runs to 50, can unload a big bomb. Nigel Smart, the distance is there!
Is clear down towards McLeod. Look at him go. Andrew McLeod. That's why he's the North Smith medalist. McLeod, Andrew.
Slapped on. McLeod's booted for maybe a bit of magic. Pulls a rabbit out of the hat. Now you see him. Now you don't. Now he can't.
Oh, back to Wren. He may have to go again. He does to Sampson. He's on the boundary line. This will be a great goal if he kicks it. Chips away.
Toya as the siren sounds. A magnificent win to Adelaide, 25-17, 167, Fremantle, 11-8, 74.
Like a 9-iron shot, Everett went up one-handed. Caven went through solidly, off the ground, kicks a goal! Costa, oh, this will be a sensational goal if he kicks it. Oh, what a beauty! Terrific stuff!
Well, they've got it up to half forward, and if it spills nicely, which it does for Caven, to McLeod, wider still, chance for Connell. He's a good finisher, Matt Connell. His kick is close. It's a goal, I think. I'd say that's a goal. As far as their defence of their title is concerned, there is the siren. So they kicked 12-10-82. Adelaide kicked 8-12-60.
Thrust in the pocket. Over the top, Kingsley, McLeod, fleet of foot, does nicely, snaps, magnificent snap, goal. Tossed in, Bickley to Jarman, Giants open goal, gets it. Let's wait for the siren. There it is.
Highlights from the first four rounds of this premiership year. Off to a slow start. Was this a premiership hangover? Only time would tell. Well, now to the official count. Presiding as usual, please welcome Chairman of the Adelaide Football Club, Bob Hammond, and Chief Executive Officer, Bill Sanders.
Round one, Carlton Optus Oval. Nathan Bassett, 31. Shane Ellen, 29. Simon Dragenza, 25. Simon Goodwin, 15. Kim Koster, 14. Mark Bickley, 11. Round two, Fremantle at Football Park. Andrew McLeod, 42. Mark Bickley, 38. Nigel Smart, 35. Clay Sampson, 24. Nathan Bassett, 17. Ben Hart, 12. Sean Wren, 6. Round three, St Kilda at Waverley Park. Mark Bickley, 32. Matt Connell, 30. Andrew McLeod, 30. David Pittman, 26. Nathan Bassett, 8. Kim Koster, 4. Chad Rintoul, 4. Nigel Smart, 4. Round 4, Port Adelaide at Football Park. Nathan Bassett, 33. Mark Ricciuto, 29. Andrew McLeod, 28. Nigel Smart, 14. Mark Bickley, 14. James Tyson, 12. Mark Stevens, 3. And that concludes the voting to the end of round 4.
And there we see our first leaderboard for the night, and Andrew McLeod, a clear leader at the moment on 100, ahead of Mark Bickley, 95, Nathan Bassett, Nigel Smart, and Matthew Connell. But a lot of votes to go, and as you can see, that their big scores can be racked up during the night. Right, so during the night, James Brayshaw will be moving among the crowd to speak to some of the Crows players. I might tell the Crows to go a little easy on James, because after all, he is a North Melbourne supporter. Go gently. James, who have you got for us?
Yeah, no, thanks very much for reminding everyone of that, Graham. I really appreciate it. If you remember last year's show, we actually had footage of the players' concert. I've got David Pittman with me here, or is it actually David St. James?
Oh, no, that was a carefully orchestrated act put together by myself and Darren Jarman and our teammates, and we practiced that pretty solidly, I guess, for about 20 minutes all up. And needless to say, we were actually pretty despondent at the end of the day that we didn't actually get up for the first prize.
All right, mate, well, don't say any more. Let's take a look at the vision.
Now, most of you know me probably as David Pittman, but I've actually got a stage name called David St. James. And other than playing football and being a stopper, I also practice a bit of hypnotism. Sleep, 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 sleep. Sleep. Whatever I tell you to do, you will do. Regardless. When you hear, leave your hat on. You will do the full Monty.
It for our act, but I can assure you that if we win today, these guys will do the full Monty.
Oh, big kiddo, a couple of those boys looked like they were enjoying that just a little too much.
Well, as I said, I think the crowd was a little bit disappointed that we didn't get the nod because there are a few guys actually pretty keen to drop their jokes.
I noticed you were talking Darren Jarman earlier. He was very absent, hiding up the back there with the running shorts underneath.
Actually, I don't know if he had any running shorts underneath. I think he rolled up to the day with nothing underneath the jeans. So yeah, he was pretty apprehensive to actually undo the belt.
All right, mate. Fantastic. Listen, enjoy the rest of the night. Congratulations on a fantastic season. We're going to take a break. Back with plenty more after this.
This weekend is Bathurst Weekend, Sunday on 7.
The October issue of Which Car compares the Camry Conquest, New Falcon Futura, Commodore Acclaim and Magna Advance. Once again, Camry was the best buy.
Simply because it can't be bettered in a blend of performance and economy. Surprisingly, perhaps, it wasn't the bigger engine Falcon and Commodore which had the best acceleration, but rather the Camry.
Test drive one to find out why Camry is Australia's best family six-cylinder car.
Thank you.
Great, thank you.
I thought that was in mothballs.
No, but I use that, it's money off the mortgage.
Inside our new Colonial Home Pack, you'll find ways to pay off your mortgage sooner and the full range of loan options, including fixed, flexi-fixed, variable and split loans. Call into a branch. We'll be happy to take you through the details.
So your bank saves you interest on your mortgage while you spend their money?
Yeah.
Your bank can buy me another beer then.
Colonial Home Pack. Wouldn't you be better off?
St. Hartlett Motors Blend Range, $9.99.
West End Drive,
$26.99.
And get a free cap.
No, a free cap.
Blend Range, $9.99.
Your Lumber Reserve Cast, $11.99.
Old Smuggler's Scotch, $21.99.
Have a good one.
If you like to sip and you want to save, you can't go past your local Sip and Save.
Aye, well, we're off for a wee break with the rains and the car was like a cope. And would you know about Kennet? Clunk, clunk, clunk. I'm stood there right glaikit with the wind shouting, "Oh, fella, you can hear nothing but a big dunderhead." So I skedaddled right into Ultratune and tell the laddie about the clunk, clunk, clunk. He says, "Oh, your shock absorbers are out the windy, man," and made a rare job of them. Understood me perfectly, he did.
Make it a long weekend in November. Step out in style. Splash out on the family and take them for a ride. Show them a great time. So jump to it now. The Adelaide International Horse Trials returns to Victoria Park Racecourse on the East Parklands from November 12 to 15. Saturday's cross-country action is free, but to secure the best seats for dressage and show jumping and details on the exclusive members club, ring Bass Dial and Charge on 131 246.
Telstra Big Pond makes it easy to do business on the internet. Let's say I sell shades. Using Big Pond, I put my product onto the World Wide Web. And I'm selling sunnies to anyone on the planet. I'm a multinational. I'm rubbing shoulders with the big guys. Big Pond Internet Services can make the net happen for you. It's easy. Just call 1-800-804-284. Big Pond. Big possibilities.
Sunday night, Pulp Fiction's John Travolta is back in Hollywood to make a killing.
I got an idea for a movie.
Have we met?
He's a mobster who's about to make a movie.
You think the movie business is any different?
One of the funniest, multi-award-winning and entertaining movie premieres this year.
I know you're acting sometimes, but you don't show it.
You thought I was faking?
Rene Russo, Gene Hackman, Danny DeVito, John Travolta.
Business is movie business. I may have to go back to Loan Shark and just to take a rest.
They're tearing the town apart to get Shorty Sunday.
Work.
but I'm sure it was all worth it. Welcome back to the Football Park Convention Centre. Earlier in the night, there were a number of awards presented for various things around the club, and tonight we're going to recognise those people. And this award is the Vice President Club's Coaches Award for the most consistently accountable player to coaches' instruction. And the winner was Simon Goodwin. And making the presentation to Simon is Dr. Michael Hayes, the chairman of the Vice President's Club. Simon, congratulations.
Thanks, Graham.
So what does this award actually mean? The coach reckons you're all right and do everything he says?
Yeah, I suppose so. I guess it means that I do a fair bit of sucking up during the year, but other than that, it's great to win.
Simon, I know it's pretty well documented, but you gave up a very promising career as a cricketer to take on footy full-time. Any regrets?
No, not at all. Not anymore. But, I still love my cricket, and it's just great that footy's gone the way it has.
So what for you over the next few weeks?
I'll head off to overseas tomorrow, so away for 4 weeks, and looking forward to it.
That's the big South African trip?
Yeah, head off to Europe first, then to South Africa.
Well, enjoy yourself, Simon. You've been a credit to yourself and to the club, and we wish you well in 99.
Thanks, Graham.
Please, thanks. Simon Goodwin. Let's see further now how the year progressed and take a look at highlights from rounds 5 through until 9.
Kilpatrick's a player to come on in.
Jamieson, a former leading goal kicker here. He goes for the first of the game. It's home.
A wobbly torpedo. Wren sits under it. He'll give it to McLeod. How much room do you want, Andy? You've got 4 or 5 acres out there, mate. Just keep going. Watch this, ladies and gentlemen.
Ronnie's not bothering. Ronnie's
going all the way to the square. Jamieson comes now. Chips to him. Goes. Costa steps out. Smart. Wrestling. The second effort, worked the contest and then died for the ball. Those were smart, great work. They've never won here at Footy Park, either against the Crows or Port Power. And this boy here is making a real stand.
McGrath did well. Gets it outside 50. Bickley, terrific hand pass. Tyson. Yes! And Sean Wren has been absolutely sensational. The Crows back on the winning list after they've lost their previous two games.
Bardi pounced on it, goes short into the pocket, finds Jarman, speak of the devil, quick snap down the foot. Magnificent kick by Jarman.
From about 35, it's to the right, but a good mark is taken by Jarman. He's got a couple there, a couple of metres that is, and he's put it through.
Picked up by Rintoul, quick hands back to Jarman, who's booted three, maybe a bit of magic, bounce it like a basketball, squeezed on the boundary line, now you see him, now you don't, Tereshudo runs into the open goal and kicks a goal.
Out of the middle by Connell, towards half forward, onto the loose ball, Rintoul goes long, and I think they've got the lead.
The time clock, the siren will sound, North Melbourne have won.
15-16 to 15-12, North Melbourne home by 4 points.
Got to try and get the ball to him to make Wren more accountable.
There's McLeod running to centre half forward. Question of accuracy. He's got it.
Towards the middle and Eccles low down.
Promising youngster. Slots it. Gutsy attempt at the mark, but the Spurs come to Barney. He's got support outside. Times the release. Goes to McLeod. McLeod from 35. And the stadium erupts.
Eccles, smart, well he has been
best on the ground.
There he goes. Knightsy takes him on. Rintoul, that's a long bomb. That's a great kick. Oh, he's dumped it. Off the ground, Jamieson. That's what the Crows needed. Boy, what a steadier. His fifth goal. And well, that's rushed through.
Deep into the forward line. Lions have the numbers. Robert gets the hand pass out. Jarman gets the step of goal for the Adelaide Crows, and he gets it away.
Hart, can he pick it up? Now he can. He snaps around the body. Great goal, Ben Hart.
Tight in the square. Pittman is the flyer from behind. Here we are. 20 metres out.
Ooh.
Oh, he's just tested Malcolm marginally. But again, it favours him. Lynch fell, scoops it up. Jarman, oh, nothing can go wrong for this side at the moment. Chip short, Jarman is the man. Oh. He eludes one tackle. He does it magnificently well. Has kicked another one. Back to the room again. He has the final kick. 14-14 to 6-14.
Well, mixed returns there in rounds 5 through 9, and of course that controversial loss to North Melbourne. Let's see how the votes went with Bill and Bob.
Round 5, Geelong at Football Park. Nigel Smart, 35. Mark Ricciuto, 32. Andrew Eccles, 31. Sean Wren, 30. Andrew McLeod, 25. Kane Johnson, 5. Round 6, North Melbourne at the MCG. Sean Wren, 41, Mark Ricciuto, 31, Brett James, 25, Andrew McLeod, 25, Nathan Bassett, 15, Chad Rintle, 10, Nigel Smart, 6. Round 7, West Coast at Football Park, Sean Wren, 36, Mark Ricciuto, 35, Nigel Smart, 30, Matt Connell, 27, Andrew McLeod, 22, Peter Caven, 5. Round 8, Richmond at Football Park, Brett James, 33, Rod Jamieson, 31, Kim Costa, 25, Ben Hart, 20, Sean Wren, 15, Nigel Smart, 10, and Troy Bond, 3. Round 9, Brisbane at the Gabba, Sean Wren, 36, Mark Ricciuto, 34, Simon Tregenza, 31, Troy Bond, 30, Darren Jarman, 17, and Nathan Bassett, 11.
And we go to the leaderboard, and we'll look at the top 10 players, starting with number 10, Kim Costa with 43, through to Mark Bickley at 6 with 95 points. Then we go to the top 5 after 9 rounds. Nathan Bassett, 115, Nigel Smart, 134, Mark Ricciuto, 161, Sean Wren, 164, and still holding the number one position, Andrew McLeod with 172, and still a long way to go. Players polling well at this stage. Let's go down to James Brayshaw and see what he's got with him at the moment.
Thank you very much, Graham. I've got Kim Costa and Peter Caven with me, but more of them in a moment. Let's take a look at this.
Well, this car is automatic, systematic. Hydromatic. Why it's greased lightning? Greased lightning. Greased lightning. Greased lightning. I got chills, they're multiplying. And I'm losing control. Cause of power, you're supplying. It's electrified.
Trying to work out what Matty Rodgren was up to there, the third player in all of that, Sandy and Danny. What do you got to say for yourself?
Yeah, well, Cabby did a very good Danny, but I will say something. I actually slept with Cabo a couple of nights ago, and I woke up in the middle of the night and he had his hand on my butt. So,
well, I was going to ask you, was there any stage during the production, Pete, where you had a look at Kim and thought, he's not looking too bad?
Well, you know, he's always in the gym working on those abracadabras, and yeah, his butt looked pretty good in those tight pants, but, you know, he shaved the leg for the occasion and all, so he really turned it on.
I heard a couple of the boys say you were struggling to keep up the lyrics there for a while.
No, we had pretty good rehearsal. We were actually pretty disappointed, like Pitto as well, of not finishing up a little bit higher. I don't know, maybe we should have showed a little bit more leg or something.
Well, I was going to ask you about that, because, of course, Matty Rodgren and yourself, women last year, do you think there's a common thread there? I'll ask you that question.
Oh, Kim's been dying to come out of the closet, but they just need that opportunity.
All right, now we're going to have to go to a break, but before I do, Kim, I've noticed the old shag's just growing up on top of the head. Are you going to let it go wild for the summer period?
Yeah, look, I've been reading a few Vogue magazines and Afros are back this summer.
Oh yeah, of course they are, mate.
Hey, look, ask Kane Johnson, they are back.
All right, that's enough from these two. We're going to take a break. We're back with plenty more in just a moment.
Saturday, Troy Dan's on a wild, wet and dangerous roundup.
This is the Outback.
Come mud bog racing.
It's good, clean fun, so to speak.
And after a bush baptism, the boys stoke up old Roger. All new Outback Adventures Saturday.
This is a side bursting with it. This is a side that has done what no other team has dreamt of. In 1997, it was the breakthrough of the improbable dream. This year, it was the impossible dream, a win from nowhere. Back-to-back premierships, the stuff legends are made of. The 1998 AFL Premiership is out now on video. Join Malcolm Blight and the Crows as they end the North Melbourne dream in one of the most dramatic matches of 1998. At these stores now.
Right now at Bets and Bets, buy any pair of shoes in the store and you can buy another pair for half price, including all the famous names. Second pair, half price, now on at Bets and Bets.
The designs, the quality, the choice of fabrics, the largest lounge specialist in South Australia at the lowest price or it's free. Sofa bed and matching sofa, unbelievable value, finest quality leather. Be pleasantly surprised at Discount Lounge Centre, Ranella, Parafil and Keswick.
We're not being judgmental here on Peter Vardy.
No, exactly right. We're not being judgmental because what he did for the Crows was magnificent.
We're having a philosophical argument. If he hadn't had the needle...
He can't play.
So, therefore, on that particular day, taking the needle hasn't enhanced his performance.
No, it hasn't. It's enabled him to play at his natural level.
He could have played.
No, he couldn't have played. Without the needle, he can't play.
So he's taking the needle, which is...
So
KG and Cornsey on 1395 Adelaide's 5AA.
End of subject. End of conversation.
Ain't that fast?
Ну, товарищи, кто первый?
Him.
Не трогать!
Красную кнопку!
What? Красную кнопку!
No worries. Just had a few lessons.
Light ice, mate.
Cheers, Al.
Hi, good beer.
A small community rocked by big-time crime.
The people that were there were looking for specific items.
They knew what to take.
The crooks were armed not just with a gun.
But how?
Upwards of $500,000 in the retail market.
And Australia's most wanted mystery, Monday.
And welcome back to the Football Park Convention Centre and a wonderful crowd we have in here tonight, and it's great to see Darren Jarman could make it. Of course, you may or may not know that he in fact missed the street parade the other day. It appears his wife locked him out of the house and he fell asleep on the front lawn and missed the parade. But he's here tonight and that's great. Great to have you here, Darren. Well, another award that was announced before the telecast tonight was the presentation of the Chairman's Club Award for Emerging Talent, and it was won by Andrew Eccles. Andrew receiving the award there from Chairman of the Chairman's Club, Clive Allard. Andrew, congratulations. Emerging Talent, when you came over from Preston Knights, what was it, this your second year?
The second year, got drafted at the end of 96.
What was your feeling having to leave home and go to a new city?
I guess at the start it was mixed feelings, probably. I would have liked to have been drafted to a Victorian club, but as it turned out, I'm happy to be over here and happy to have won a premiership.
Yeah, premierships are pretty scarce over the border, actually.
Well, the last couple of years they have been, so it's great that I'm in this city.
How do you see your future with the club? Where would you like to be playing?
What position?
What position?
Probably, I'll say at the wing at the moment, because had not a bad run there this year, so hopefully stay there.
And you don't mind kicking a goal or two?
The occasional goal doesn't hurt, I think. I don't mind that.
Well, Andrew, great performance this year, and all the best for 99.
Thank you.
Andrew Eccles. And let's have a look at the highlights now of the next round of matches, and as the team was sort of gearing up towards the premiership rounds.
White does the work at ground, or Seacamp can't get it away. He's caught on the right foot. He's got the first one for the Crows, hard up in the pocket. Drags it back around, bounces once in the square. Downsborough makes something out of nothing and goals. Left foot goes to the square, up they go. Melbourne knock it down, only into the path of Eccles. Throws it beautifully and goals. Big talk for the square. Jarman in front, drops it down in front, has a second go. Steps around, thank you on the right. Rem, you're a champion. Jarman, you're not bad. Adelaide finishing all over the top of Melbourne. They need something here. Kane Godson's kicked their smother. They get another chance through Vardy. Peter Vardy for the Adelaide Crows has kicked a much-needed goal.
Hurriedly floats it towards half forward. Ellis came over the top. Vardy running hard. Moves inside the 50. Question of accuracy. Great finish.
Peter Vardy still going. Shrugs the curly tackle. Goes into the pocket. Clay Sampson's there. Tries to bend it back, and he does so to Downsborough.
To all work hard in and under the packs.
Downsborough for his second. He needs to swing it back. Takes it into half forward.
Big pack of players.
Oh, the back is a good one. Another one of the Crows.
Western Bulldogs have recorded eventually a very impressive win. 24-11, 155 to Adelaide, 13-10, 88.
Days away, up towards half forward. Wren was in front, but he couldn't take the mark. Rashudo, not Rashudo. First one way, then the other. Sweeps the hand pass roll. Back to Peter Vardy again. Going into the square, Nigel Smart, the fly up on the high. A big kick, put the ball. A big goal by Adelaide, that one. Very good kick, no mark taken. Quayle is the call for Tyson Dove. Here's Rodrin. They lead by a point. Wren can't take it. James neither. Costa, yes. Kim Costa out in the middle. Rashudo floats it even wider. Vardy can answer immediately. Because there's the sun.
Rashudo pushed out. No whistle. Burns and Bond. Bond's kicked two already. He's only 25 metres out. That's clever. Robren. Bond for his fourth. Great hands. Running away from goal. Now gets a sight of them and snaps back the goal. Another one. Vardy goes longer to the goal square. Oh, Robren!
Beautiful play.
And then goes into a pile of tackle on Razzo. Bond's in the area. Costa goes back to Vardy. 40 metres out on the boundary line. Has a look at them. And have a look at this!
Oh, that's sensational. Let's see if Pittman can take the run out and take the mark. He's got the jump. And the mark.
Oh, well called. Dealing here because Pittman, I'm sure, will go. He does.
Bond!
He does that so well.
That's a good grab, Bond, yes. Because Buckley was caught back with Bickley.
Well, Bond kicked four in the first half. This for number five. And the Crows fans like it. The best quarter has been the last. James. And pass to McLeod. He's slippery. He can't catch this fella. He goes for goal and kicks it.
Grind, the move paid off.
Yeah. And there's the siren. The Crows are up against Collingwood at the MCG at last.
And there was the showing of our mid-season form that was to take us onwards to the finals. And now let's have a look how the players voted. Here's Bill.
Round 10, Melbourne at Football Park. Brett James, 37. Troy Bond, 36. Peter Caven, 31. Nathan Bassett, 24. Matt Connell, 10. Simon Goodwin, 10. Shane Allen, 6. Simon Dragenza, 5. Round 11, Western Bulldogs at Optus Oval. Kim Costa, 32. Peter Vardy, 32. Simon Goodwin, 23. Peter Caven, 20. Sean Wren, 8. Shane Allen, 7. Round 12, Essendon at Football Park. Matthew Robron, 32. Simon Goodwin, 28. Peter Vardy, 25. Brett James, 21. James Tyson, 12. Sujay Cook, 9. Mark Rusciuto, 4. Round 13, Collingwood at the MCG. Simon Goodwin, 40. Nigel Smart, 36. Troy Bond, 33. Ben Hart, 26. Andrew McLeod, 23. James Tyson, 4. And that concludes the voting to round 13.
Thanks, Bill. Some good-hearted banter there, And looking through rounds 1 to 13, the top 10. The bottom half of that, Matthew Connell, 67, Kim Costa, 75, Mark Bickley, 95, Brett James, 116, along with Simon Goodwood, who had a good mid-season, 116. And the top five at this stage, Nathan Bassett in fifth, 139, Mark Rusciuto, 165, one of the favourites, Nigel Smart, 170, Sean Wren, 172, and Andrew McLeod, 195. Will the winner come from that lot? There's still a lot of rounds to go. James. How are you doing? Where are you now, mate?
I'm having a great time, thanks, Graham. I've got Simon Goodings. Goodings, there you go.
Thank you very much.
You've inherited him. And a fair one, too, that last four or five games. And Simon Goodwin, of course, and Mark Bickley. Now, we've got more of the players' concert coming right up, so have a bit of a look at this. Geez, aren't I the thorn between two roses? We'll start with you, Mark Bickley. Whose idea was that?
Well, I delegated this one, being captain. Normally I said, well, I'll leave it to the young guys. Simon Goodwin, Kane Johnson and Tyson Edwards took control of it, and that's what we ended up with.
Well, I was just going to say, actually, Tony Modra and James Tyson were the other players featuring there. But Simon Goodwin, the costumes looked good, but the dancing was horrendous.
Yeah, we actually got together on Sunday morning for about half an hour, and that's what we came up with, and it was very, very average.
Who let you down? Who was your worst performer?
Well, Skipper came up with the original idea of Riverdance, and we sort of canned that, and then he came up with that. So, yeah, we got to put the blame on Skipper, but it was very average.
What is it about players dressing up as women, Mark? It seems a lot of your club seem to enjoy doing it. The legs give it away for me, but what is it? It seems to be a theme that's running through the whole thing.
Oh, I think it's just like drinking. You know, you suppress it for 52 weeks of the year, and then you get that one chance, so you all get in there. So.
All right, what about the moves there? What happened? Was it just a disaster from the start, or did you lose the sort of rhythm of the thing?
I don't think any of us had any rhythm to lose. But the only good thing was is that you couldn't actually recognise who we were, and that was the only saving grace that we had.
All right, Simon Goodwin, seeing as how it was your idea, what are you going to come up with next year?
Well, I've been in two groups in 2 years, and we've come last every time, so hopefully something a lot better.
All right, now before I let you go, Simon just had a boomer there. I've been sitting next to him for three games and he's polled in every one of them. Unfortunately, the same can't be said for yourself. Mark, what's happening?
I just thought while we got the microphone, might just slip in that Mark Bickley, 50 points. Can we do that?
You can. Whether it'll cut any mustard, I don't know. We're going to take a break. Back with plenty more in a moment.
Seven Nightly News, here's Noola Hafner with tonight's weather.
Good evening. Some patchy rain and isolated thunderstorms will become confined to the northern interiors tomorrow, but isolated showers will temporarily increase in the south tomorrow morning. A strong wind warning has been issued for the southeast coast, and southwesterly winds will freshen on local waters. Cloudy in the city with a shower or two clearing by afternoon, up to a top of 19. Fine and mild Sunday, warm but cloudy with some late rain Monday. Good night.
Hanson, Everlast, cool. And this week they're having a humongous sale. Hundreds of specials up to half price.
Kappa tracksuits, half price. Kappa jackets, half price.
Umbro t-shirts, $17. This is a big sale.
Running shoes, tennis shoes, cricket shoes, cross trainers, street shoes, outdoor kids shoes.
Thousands of shoes up for grabs.
Soccer shirts, tennis rackets, AFL gear, heaps of Crows gear.
Mr. Bellotti said you may never, ever see prices like this again. Bellotti Sports.
They're not cool, but geez, they're cheap.
Fire up, it's free. The Adelaide Spa Show this Saturday, Sunday and Monday. Talk to the experts about spa pools and spa baths with special show prices you can't afford to miss it. The Adelaide Spa Show, 3 days only this long weekend at Duncan Hall, Wayville Showgrounds. It's free.
We're not being judgmental here on Peter Vardy.
Because no, exactly right. We're not being judgmental. What he did for the Crows was magnificent.
We're having a philosophical argument. If he hadn't had the needle...
He can't play.
So therefore, on that particular day, taking the needle hasn't enhanced his performance.
No, it hasn't. It's enabled him to play at his natural level.
He could have played.
No, he couldn't have played. Without the needle, he can't play.
So he's taking the needle, which is...
So
KG and Cornsey on 1395 Adelaide's 5AA.
End of subject. End of conversation.
The Mobile Phone Centre. SA's number one Telstra mobile net dealer. Get the latest, the Nokia 6110. We call this human technology. Available now from the Mobile Phone Centre. Franklin Street, Gawler Place, Holden Hill. Your showcase for the latest technology. The Mobile Phone Centre.
More buyers, more sellers, every day Australia-wide.
Nobody does it better.
Do you like it?
Thank you, Mr. Hooker.
LJ Hooker, you're the best.
Freedom, what is
honcho. I wonder what I'd do if they all did just what I said.
And welcome back to the 1998 Crows Club Championship Award. I'm sorry I'm laughing there, but Coach Malcolm Blight just came back to his seat and was almost knocked out. I think I know why he ducked out. He's trying to get hints on how to become Coach of the Year. But obviously, two premierships won't do it for you, Malcolm, but I'm sure we'll work out a way. Well, it's time now to find out the best team man, an award to be presented by the Mayor of the City of Charles Sturt, Mr. John Dyer. John?
Thank you, Graham. I'm pleased to announce the best team man for the best team in Australia, and that is Peter Cavan.
Peter Cavan. And the best team man, second only to club champion, judged by the management committee. It takes into account not only performances during the season, but leadership qualities on and off the field. Peter, step this way. Well, you came to the Adelaide Crows in 1996. I guess your career was at the crossroads. Did you have high expectations at that point?
Oh, yeah. I had high expectations to come back. I mean, obviously it was disappointing getting cut by Sydney, but you know, Robert gave me opportunity a couple of years ago, and you know, he more or less said, I'll back you. So, you know, had a big look in the mirror, and I mean, still here today.
You were given probably one of the toughest jobs in football, centre-half back. You meet a big, tough, strong, classy player every week. Pretty daunting task.
Oh, early in the week, I probably wasn't playing. Early in the year, I wasn't playing half back so much. I'd probably play more on the flank and picking up the quick little pocket players and that sort of thing. But you know, later in the year, I got settled back at centre half back, and just tried to be a little bit more consistent than I was early in the year. And you know, each week, Malcolm had faith in me, and some weeks it worked, some weeks it didn't. So just in the end, it turned out. So everyone's pretty happy.
It must be great to have that support of a coach, so you know a little mistake is not going to go punished, and you can go on and.
Oh, you get a couple of chances. The runner came out a fair few times, a couple of times, but you get a couple of chances.
Oh, yeah, there's a couple of blokes named Grant and Kerry who are going to be looking for you next year.
I wouldn't be surprised, but no, that's footy.
Well, it's a wonderful award for you to win, Peter. It's a credit to yourself for what you've done for the Adelaide Football Club. I mean, you shudder to think what would have happened if Peter Cavan had been standing at centre-half back in the two last games of the year. Let's thank Peter Cavan. Well done, mate.
I'd just like to thank my girlfriend Nicole and my little daughter Isabella. Thanks very much.
Peter Cavan. Well, on with the count now, and our mid-season charge began to falter slightly. Let's look at the highlights from round 14 through 17.
Shortman standing 25 metres out straight in front.
He's trying the check side. Just as not well a kick bad there. Kick. That's a sensational kick.
Bucks go at it again. It favours Wren. He calculates it, comes down, gets the handball to a shooter. Very, very clever play. Cool under pressure is Wren, and riding onto the footy is Marsh. It looked like he pulled up a little gingerly. Lining up, very, very deliberate. Adelaide, the quick reply. One would think, yes, not just agile, but accurate. So the Swans have been answered.
The target there was Dunklage. He's going to be asked to do a lot today, Dunklage. Bickley tackled superbly to Rusciuto. Champagne footy and hits Marsh. Oh, that was good.
I don't think we can blame Paul Roos for that one. That was just a terrific bit of offence for out of defence.
This has been a very big debut. Kicks from 50. Close. I think he's got his third. He has.
He has having a blinder. As the rucks go at it again, Wren and O'Fell comes to ground, has got it on the string, McLeod bustling through, Rodman, he's having a day out as well, they are just on fire as Tyson throws it on the left foot, there's another one if you don't mind.
As Wren in the dying seconds finishes it off, and Adelaide are comprehensive winners here at the SCG this afternoon.
Gets good distance once more, out came Big Marsh, here's Rusciuto. He's got it. But they need someone at ground level. Jarman with a bit of magic. Bounces through. Right on siren time.
The Crows have won out convincing winners here at Hawthorn.
And a ride, and it's Gallagher. Rusciuto takes a wonderful mark.
And he's kicked towards full forward. Gee, Rusciuto really got on that too. He's going to kick a goal anyway. Able to recover the crumbs and kick the goal.
Marsh made a contest of it. Costa's handball was excellent to Edwards, who should goal from 40 metres out, and he's done it. That's beautiful football by the Crows, one end to the other. Franchina, Rusciuto, Ratten under pressure, Rusciuto able to get hold of it, and Rusciuto goes for goal, and cleverly goes. Beautiful check side kick. Improvisation at its very best there.
He goes for Vodra. Manton's back there, but Vodra's done well. I think football fans all over Australia just love to see this man playing Aussie rules footy. Vodra from only 30, 35 metres goes for goal. He's got it. He's kicked the goal.
Ball on the up. Ran over to the Blues. The Blues have won it. Going to Parko.
Connell again, handball to Jarman, who should finish, and he did. Much needed goal there for the Crows.
And Carroll's been able to hold him up. Sinclair unable to take him, and Jarman kick his third. Bang, straight through the middle. Fourth like that. Parker's after it, in trouble. Smart, it was a sandwich. Smart kicked the goal, Crows in front. Well done, Renda, put the pressure on with Vardy. Back to Modra, good hands. Rusciuto, beautiful handball. James, nice kick. Here's a goal. Vardy goes in and kicks it. They're a good side and they're keeping coming.
He goes for the big torpedo, gets onto it, kicks it to full forward. The mark's been taken. Riley coming off the ground as Jarman goes for goal number 8. He's got it. Can you believe it? They've won it.
And at that point, things looked a little shaky. But the best, as in all good novels, is yet to come. Let's look at the votes from round 14 to 17 with Bob Hammond.
Round 14, Sydney at the SCG, Mark Rusciuto, 39, Mark Bickley, 26, Simon Goodwin, 24, Sean Wren, 21, Brett James, 18, Nigel Smart, 17, Matthew Robron, 11, Ben Hart, 7. Round 15, Hawthorn at Football Park, Sean Wren, 44, Nigel Smart, 36, Mark Bickley, 32, Mark Rusciuto, 29, Darren Jarman, 25, and Brett James, 7. Round 16, Carlton at Football Park, Simon Goodwin, 28, Mark Bickley, 26, Mark Rusciuto, 20, Ben Hart, 16, Nigel Smart, 16. Round 17, Fremantle at Subiaco, Darren Jarman, 41, Mark Rusciuto, 33, Mark Bickley, 26, David Pittman, 23, Simon Goodwin, 11, and Kane Johnson, 8, and that concludes the voting to round 17.
And let's go straight to the leaderboard. And the leaderboard shows us, looking 10 through 6, Darren Jarman 83, Troy Bond 102, Nathan Bassett in 8, 139, Brett James 141, Simon Goodwin still hanging in there well with 179. And to the top 5 positions. And the favourites are certainly moving right to the top. Andrew McLeod has eased back a little, 195, Mark Bickley on 205, Sean Wren 237, Nigel Smart, 239, and out in front, Mark Rusciuto on 286 votes. But I might remind you that not only do we have the minor round to come, we also have the final. So there are lots of votes in there still up for grabs. Out with the roving camera, here's James.
We certainly are. Thank you very much, Graham. Our final act from the Players' Concert involves Ben Hart and Rod Jamieson. Here's Ben, of course, next to me. We're going to speak to you in just a second, so relax, because here's the vision.
Uh-huh. From one lover to another, uh-huh.
I can't live without you if the love was gone. Everything is nothing if you got no way. You've been walking the night, slowly losing sight of the real.
got no doubt. Too deep in love and we got no way out. And the message is clear. This could be the year for the real thing.
No more will you cry. Maybe I will hurt you never. We start and end as one.
They last forever. We can ride it together. Uh-huh. Making love with each other.
Oh, that's magnificent. Ben Hart and Rod Jamieson. The mullet or the screw-in stops there, Ben?
No, I don't know about the singing, but there's a fair set, though. All right.
Now, I thought Jamo looked more like Grizzly Adams than Kenny Rogers there. But what about the singing? Obviously, the audio guy didn't fold the sound down quite enough.
Yeah, so correct. I thought I sounded a lot better when I was out there, but obviously... the things took over in front of me, so it was all right.
Can you give us a little rendition? Have you got that in you? Can you give us a couple of bars?
No way.
How much rehearsing went into that act?
Oh, it was at least 3 or 4 minutes, I reckon.
And can you tell us where you came in the scheme of things?
I think we came about third. Same as David, I thought we should have been up around, last or probably.
I noticed Rod Jamieson's been conspicuous in his absence through all of this. Now, you've got something you want to quickly mention, I gather?
These little babies. Sports in Motion, just my new business I started. Just if you're after a promotion, think of that and think of me.
You're kidding me, aren't you? That's amazing behaviour. All right, while we're rolling, you may as well just throw to a break, eh?
Okay, we'll take a short break and we'll be back with plenty more in a moment.
The October issue of Which Car compares the Camry Conquest, New Falcon Futura, Commodore Acclaim and Magna Advance. Once again, Camry was the best buy.
Simply because it can't be bettered in a blend of performance and economy. Surprisingly, perhaps, it wasn't the bigger engine Falcon and Commodore which had the best acceleration, but rather the Camry.
Test drive one to find out why Camry is Australia's best family six-cylinder car.
Getting away.
Oh, hi, Dad.
Just called to see if my little girl's looking after herself.
Yes, Dad, your little girl is looking after herself.
97% fat-free. Healthy choice is looking after yourself.
Rocker Brothers have pulled out all stops to bring you the biggest bargains in their spring sale catalogue.
Home brand motor oil, a bargain at only $10.95 for 6 litres.
Red hot price.
A million candle power quartz halogen rechargeable spotlight, only $44.95.
Great!
Sperling Vegas washable hard-wearing seat covers, cheap at $24.50 a pair.
A bargain!
Rockers have a large range of child seats like Clip and Child Booster, only $59.
For these and other great bargains, pop into your local Rocker Brothers store.
They have a cheaper than the others, so rock and roll the brothers!
Check the catalogue out now.
Authentic pepperoni, ham, cabanossi, beef and bacon. It's all on the Pizza Haven Meat Supreme.
For your Pizza Haven, call up Pizza Haven tonight.
Ну, товарищи, кто первый?
Хим.
Не трогать!
Красную кнопку!
Вот красную кнопку!
No worries. Is that a few lessons?
Light ice, mate.
Cheers, Al.
Good boy, good beer.
an election for the new millennium. Australia goes to the polls. We talk to the voters, look at the last minute swings and ask the experts for their predictions on a special edition of 7 Nightly News. The Voice of the People at 6 o'clock on 7. On Today Tonight, the Adelaide school outrage, videoed by the teachers.
Enough is enough.
An 8-year-old distressed and injured, but no one helps. They just keep filming to prove she's a problem at school. 6:30 Monday.
Oh, Baba, let's spend the night together. Now I need you more than ever. Let's spend the night together.
Well, welcome back to the Football Park Convention Centre, and we're getting closer to the big moment. Well, Toyota have been sponsoring the Crows since the beginning, and I think it's been a pretty good partnership for both parties involved. And I'd like now for you to welcome the Director of Sales and Marketing for Toyota Australia, Tom Phillips, with a special announcement. Tom.
Thank you, Graham. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The Chairman of the Adelaide Football Club, Bob Hammond, directors, players and officials, and all the supporters of the team that is the pride of South Australia, I'm delighted tonight to represent Toyota Australia and make the following presentations. Firstly, I have a cheque to the value of $50,000 payable to the Adelaide Football Club as a token of appreciation by Toyota and the Adelaide Metropolitan Dealers for your efforts in the final series. I'd like to present that to Mark Bickley. I should add it's made out to the Adelaide Football Club, not M. Bickley. Further, last year after the first premiership, Toyota donated a car to the Adelaide Football Club, a Toyota Camry, which was used in fundraising activity. This year, two premierships, two cars. If you win more than four or five or six, I might have a problem, but I can get away with three. The first car we will give you this year is actually the new fully imported Corolla, which was only released yesterday. So you'll have one of those to, which I'm sure Bill will be able to use to great advantage for the club. And at a time when the club wishes, we will give them another car to use in their fundraising. As you may be aware, Toyota, one of our main themes is that we are here for the long run. We've been proud to be associated with the Adelaide Football Club since its inception in 1991. For 8 years now, we have been their major sponsor, and I'm pleased to advise that tonight, that sponsorship, in conjunction with the Metropolitan and now also the rural South Australian dealers, will continue until at least the year 2001. After the back-to-back success that this football club has just enjoyed, I'd like to finish off by wishing that in 1999 the phrase, Crows three in a row is the way to go, becomes not just a dream, but by this time next year, a reality.
A hat-trick.
Congratulations on your success, and once again, thank you for allowing Toyota to be part of your team. We're even giving up our worldwide theme of Oh What a Feeling. From now on, it's Crows Oh What a Feeling. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Tom Phillips from Toyota Australia, and lots of smiling faces around the Adelaide Football Club. Well, let's get back to business now, and we're certainly getting to the business end of the season. Let's take a look at the highlights from rounds 18 through to 22.
Here's the lead. It's going to get there. Jarman high on the shoulder, but let go. Here's McLeod. Runs in. McLeod's got it again. Tonight he's been run down. Waitland has made a real mess of this one. Gives Cook the chance. Brings it back around to the top of the square. McLeod, another go at it. Now that is three now.
inside half forward. Jarman's in the chop. It comes to Vardy at the front. Vardy's a would-be tackler. Peter Vardy, an open goal.
Connell out of the centre bounds. Up towards Jarman with Hodgson. Vardy again. He's found some room. He's moved around onto the right. He's opened up the goal face. He's kicked another. They are just pounding him. Now kicks towards centre half forward. Pittman, very good. Flicks it over the back. Ben Hart from centre half back. Runs down. Kicks the goal for the Crows. Cook. Tim Cook does the roving. Brings it back. Great work, Vardy.
To the goal square. Rodrin's there. He's got it. The crowd have actually booed Vardy, I think. What a terrific game by the Adelaide team, Drew.
Port had numbers, but the puck comes to the front. Big chance now with Jarman. 35 metres out. DJ gets it there. Here's Modra from Connell's kick, but he won't go down for Jarman. And Modra. Point blank range.
Umpire said that he pulled the ball in.
Robin, a good mark. That plays on away from Mead. Kick by Robin. Scotcher! Right.
It's probably curtains for the final should the result continue this way.
Oh, well played. Liptak. Jarman, good mark. McCaven for his second goal. 74 points.
Goal square. Up high. Under pressure, Robin Vardy.
Oh. How did he give it to him?
The steal of the day so far.
Not happy again, thinking Raleigh should have got a free kick. Robin down towards Modra. Roving the pack there, that was Tyson. Tyson towards Modra, great mark. Oh, what a good one. That's vintage Modra. Low down, diving, plenty of courage there. Obviously paying the price for that mistake across half back. Menzai Modra has two now, and the lead is stretched.
I like Mark Rusciuto too. He's going back and steadying.
Oh! Tony Modra!
Oh, well.
And he's kicked 2-3. If he kicks this, he could have kicked 3. Maybe even one of those behinds that he's kicked. And his return could have been 4. It still could be 4. And then kicks in the direction of Modra.
Oh!
He's had to adjust and just outreach Simpson. And unfortunately, the young fellow's had a tough day. Going for goal number 5, Tony Modra. And he's got it.
Second half goals across to James on the siren. And they make some history for the Adelaide Crows. Total sellout and a live coverage you're seeing on 7 throughout South Australia. Tyson Edwards gets the hand pass.
Team have got more, the greater ability to just generate some sort of run into their play. They seem to find space far better than the North Melbourne team at this stage.
Edwards plays on. And it goes! Modra and Martin and Scott. Here's a chance. A snap. It's high! And a not so. Nigel has done it. Last kick in the game. North Melbourne at home in an absolute thriller.
Across the half forward line, Rockland gets rid of McIntosh to swoop on it as Modra. Oh. What a goal by Tony Modra!
I tell you what, Robert.
A beauty!
Into the path of Hetty, coming up is Wooden. Well, Wooden far too slow. It was Wooden. It's grabbed there by McLeod. McLeod kicks it. Goal, and that's a magnificent goal. What was Wooden thinking? Quickly a high kick down towards the pocket. Ball goes back. Missed it. Vardy quickly across to Jarman. Open goal. Runs in. Kicks it. His second.
Goes towards half forward. Jarman. Beautifully done. Bickley will go in and get the goal. Mark Bickley from 20 metres. Goes in. And he's kicked it. Much to the delight of Tony Modra. David Pittman. Another knockout. He's 20th. And it's been a good performance by the Adelaide Crows here at Subiaco.
And the team really starting to swing into top gear by round 22. And wasn't the showdown nice to see again, eh? Do we enjoy that or what? And there'll be two more next year. Well, rounds 18 to 22. How did the players poll? Here's Bill Sanders.
Round 18, St Kilda at Football Park. Mark Rusciuto, 39. Sean Wren, 37. Nigel Smart, 35. Matt Connell, 34. Andrew McLeod, 34. Round 19, Port Adelaide at Football Park. Mark Rusciuto, 40. Peter Vardy, 39. Ben Hart, 33. Matt Connell, 32. Simon Goodwin, 11. Andrew McLeod, 6. Sean Wren, 6. Nigel Smart, 6. Round 20, Geelong at Cardinia Park. Mark Rusciuto, 42. Andrew McLeod, 39. Ben Hart, 34. Simon Goodwin, 24. Kim Costa, 18. Mark Stevens, 12. Nigel Smart, 6. Round 21, North Melbourne at Football Park. Simon Goodwin, 39. David Pittman, 28. Nigel Smart, 25. Tyson Edwards, 21. James Tyson, 14. Andrew McLeod, 9. Round 22, West Coast, Subiaco. Simon Goodwin, 36. David Pittman, 36. Mark Rusciuto, 35. Kane Johnson, 29. Peter Caven, 15. Ben Hart, 6. Andrew McLeod, 6. And that concludes the minor round voting to round 22.
And there we look at the leaders board. And that is after the minor round completed. But you will remember that there are four games to go. So looking from 10 back to 6, Nathan Bassett, 139. Matthew Connell, 133, not quite in order. Brett James, 141. Ben Hart, 154. Mark Bickley, still polling well, 205. And the top five. Sean Wren, 280. Simon Goodwin, 289. Andrew McLeod, 289. Nigel Smart, 311. Mark Rusciuto, 442. Mark with a big lead, but as we said, four games to go, a possible 200 votes up for grabs, so just about anyone in that top five is still in with a big chance of winning. We'll take a break from the Football Park Convention Centre.
The Crows' finest hour without all the stress and anxiety of watching it live. The grand final begins again next on 7.
Wait for this weekend. Thousands of dollars of furniture will be sold at half price. Bedding will be sold at half price. Carpets will be sold at half price. Saturday, Sunday, Monday, all this long weekend. Oh, I can't wait. The Core News.
There you go.
Magnificent.
St. Helens Places Blend Range, $9.99.
West End Drive,
$26.99. And get a free cap.
No, a free cap.
Peter Lynn Range, $9.99.
Your Lumber Reserve
Cask, $11.99.
Old Smuggler's Scotch,
$21.99.
Have a good one.
If you like to sip and you want to save, you can't go past your local Sip and Save.
My dad's an advertising. He asked me to do an ad for Bloody Sport. But I said, Bloody Sports? Come on, Dad, they're not cool. Helly Hansen? Everlast? Cool! And this week they're having a humongous sale. Hundreds of specials up to half price.
Kappa tracksuits, half price. Kappa jackets, half price.
Umbro t-shirts, $17. This is a big sale.
Running shoes, tennis shoes, cricket shoes, cross trainers, street shoes, outdoor kid shoes.
Thousands of shoes up for grabs.
Soccer shirts, tennis rackets, AFL gear, heaps of Crows gear. Mr. Belotti said you may never, ever see prices like this again. Belotti Sports, they're not cool, but geez, they're cheap.
To get the best price, get the sign that sells on your phone.
Nobody does it better.
Do you like it?
Thank you, Mr. Hooker.
LJ Hooker, you're the best.
No monthly fees! No monthly fees!
If your home loan monthly fees are going through the roof, switch to the credit union with no monthly fees and a very low one-year fixed rate. Savings and loans.
Wait, wait, wait for this weekend. Thousands of dollars of furniture will be sold at half price. Bedding will be sold at half price. Carpets will be sold at half price. Saturday, Sunday, Monday, all this long weekend. Oh, I can't wait. The Core News.
Only you.
If you're looking for a naughty little treat, then buckle up.
I'm okay.
Lloyd Bridges and Charlie Sheen.
Seems no matter what I do, I end up hurting someone.
In the laugh-a-minute hit Hot Shot, Saturday on 7.
This weekend, see the running of a great race without a politician in sight. The AMP Bathurst 1000, Sunday, 7:30 on 7.
And welcome back to the Crows Club Champion Award for 1998. Another award that was announced before the telecast this evening was the Members MVP Award. And this was decided upon by the gold and silver members of the Adelaide Football Club. And Raylene Carruthers was drawn to present the award to the winner, Nigel Smart. Nigel, that's a pretty nice award to win, isn't it, from the members?
Yeah, I thought I was going to drop it there for a minute. So it's actually a very nice award. Probably the players would like to express at this time that the members for the Adelaide Football Club are a vital part of the football club. We try and show our appreciation that at most occasions the players do think of the members quite often. And I suppose from the players' point of view, we just want to thank the members for a great supporting year.
And Nigel, we all want to thank you. Nigel Smart. A club is nothing if it doesn't have its members. Right, now let's move on and look at the highlights from the finals round, the all-important finals round, to see who will be the club Crows champion.
Collected by Ricciuto, who comes at him again. McLeod, lovely ball work. McLeod at centre wing, this is what the crowd loves to see from that champ on the Ricciuto. Ricciuto down towards Modra, perfect play, the best forward play from Adelaide so far. 439 career goals to Tony Modra, can he make it 440? That looks pretty good, the goal umpire will indicate 4 points.
Stands and delivers to the square. Smart's got it. Didn't play the last time these two sides met, he was suspended. Probably run around. Tough angle. He's got it.
Woden's kick up to half forward and Farmer couldn't take the mark. Melbourne in its first finals appearance since 1984. Robin to James to Bay. This is dangerous as he shoots in towards goal and he's put it through. His lurking danger to it doesn't come his way. Once again, pressure on the defence. Orchard is beaten. Here's the North Smith medalist.
I think a moment ago when James was on the bottom, I think a couple of the Swans players remembered something that happened earlier tonight. Vardy to kick number six.
He's done it again.
He's done it again. Vardy's kicked six.
Just in the Crows' attacking zone, Ren to Dunkley. It's all over. It is all over for Sydney. Adelaide will march on.
Mason goes off the ground, picks it up. McLeod, well, he's got it now. He turns around and he's kicked the goal.
The left footer will chip in towards Robro. Kick the 2 metres from home. Go all the way, big man. And he does.
intent on destruction, knocked it down in front. This is James, about 35 metres out. Pulls it back. It's bending around.
Oh, you don't mind.
Down towards half forward. Yeah, it's a close quarters to McLeod. Going at number five. He's got it. I think. Right on the umpire. Did it carry? Yes, it did. Quickly. Moves away. Robin again. Just outside the 50. And what we've seen today, not beyond his range. It kicks from about 55. The man behind him is too close. He kicks the goal anyway.
Out the back it goes and in towards the pocket. Kept in play, Herber. Well done by Jarman. He bends it back.
Squeezes it, Robren nearly, clever, handball to Johnson, Johnson tried to break it, McLeod, brilliantly done, back to Johnson, Johnson goes, and he's kicked it, they're back!
It's long, Vardy! Couldn't take them out, it doesn't matter because Jarman is there, and Jarman is back too!
Crows kicked 6-1 to 2-2 against the Saints in last year's grand final. In the third quarter, he's kicked the goal, there's 7 points in front.
Smart in front, Freeborn's got him, he gets a kick! A ridiculous kick!
Plenty of options, Jarman, Vardy, 20 metres out, very sharp angle, but you can guess the result.
Well, I tell you what, no matter how many times you see it, it still sends a chill down the spine, doesn't it? Ah, dear idea. If we had all night, we'd play it again. The grand final's coming up straight after this, so you can relive it all. Well, now let's see how the final votes went. Here's Bob Hammond.
Qualifying final, Melbourne at the MCG. Tyson Edwards, 24. Darren Jarman, 23. Nigel Smart, 22. Simon Goodwin, 14. Ben Hart, 6. Peter Cavan, 2. Mark Stevens, 2. Second semi-final at Sydney at the SCG. Peter Vardy, 39. Nigel Smart, 33. Peter Cavan, 28. Ben Hart, 19. Sean Wren, 10. James Tyson, 10. Mark Ricciuto, 6. Kim Costa, 5. And Darren Jarman, 5. Preliminary final, Western Bulldogs at MCG. Matthew Robren, 40. Andrew McLeod, 36. Sean Wren, 34. Peter Cavan, 26. Tyson Edwards, 22. Ben Hart, 6. Nigel Smart, 5. Grand Final, North Melbourne at the MCG. Andrew McLeod, 41. Ben Hart, 36. Peter Cavan, 34. Kane Johnson, 29. Sean Wren, 20. Mark Bickley, 14. And Darren Jarman, 7. And it's my pleasure to announce Mark Ricciuto, the winner, with 448.
The 1998 Adelaide Club champion, missed the premiership in 97 through injury. The club said they did it for him this year and for Peter Vardy, and he's certainly done it for all of us. A former winner of the Best Team Man Award, and it was always inevitable that one day Mark Ricciuto would be club champion. And the current club champion, Andrew McLeod, in his gold jacket, will give Mark Ricciuto his when he finally gets here through the players. And there you see the leaderboard, the top 10, Nathan Bassett, Brett James, Peter Cavan, Mark Bickley and Ben Hart. And moving on, Simon Goodwin, Sean Wren, Andrew McLeod, Nigel Smart and Mark Ricciuto with 448, our winner.
My pleasure to officially announce Mark as the club champion. He's had an outstanding season and truly a worthy winner, Mark Ricciuto.
from one champion to another. The 1998 champion, Mark Ricciuto. Well, Mark, I guess it doesn't get any better than this. You missed out last year on the big one, and not only did you get that premiership medallion, you're now club champion. How do you feel?
So I don't really know what to say. I haven't been this nervous since grand final morning. So just very honoured to win an award, which four of them, well, close mates, won the last few years, and honoured to be in their situation that I've been in recently.
Would you please charge your glasses and be upstanding as we toast our new champion?
Over the drink.
We're toasting you. The 1998 Adelaide Crows Club champion, Mark Ricciuto. Mark, I'm sure there are a few words you'd like to say.
Obviously, I'd like to thank especially the teammates that won the premiership last year and butted up and trained very hard pre-season and fought all year. We've had a lot of injuries and used 38 players, I think, this year, so it was a great effort to butter up again and win another flag. And I feel for Matty Liptak and Simon Dragenza and Tony Modra and the other players that missed out last year. And also to the players that missed out this year, I know how it feels to miss out in the grand final, and it's not a good feeling, but I suppose Peter, Vardy and I were very lucky to be part of it this year, and I'd like to thank the Adelaide Football Club and the players, and from the coaching staff down to Gary Googe and the trainers and everyone associated with the club for putting in a fantastic effort this year again.
Mark, any of us that saw the grand final last year could see on the looks of faces, your face and Tony Modra's, Matthew Liptak, you were thrilled for the team, but that deep disappointment. Did you really think that you'd be getting an opportunity so soon?
Oh, I was hoping so, but I didn't think it would happen the next year, but there was no hangover. We started slowly this year, but I think we had a lot of operations over the summer. It took us a while to get back into top gear, but no, we just kept training hard all year and all through the finals, and I think we got what we deserved in the long run.
A lot of players would say it was your enthusiasm, yours, Peter Vardy's. You hadn't been there before. It was all new to you, and that also spurred them on.
It takes a lot more than two players to win a grand final, and certainly I didn't play that well during the finals, and Peter had a couple of good games, but it was just the young players that lifted and played well every week, and we had great team performances all through the finals, bar the Melbourne game, and that's what got us there in the end.
Been a pretty good year for you all round, 21 votes in the Brownlow. You could have gone on and won it last year, but for injury. So the world is still your oyster.
I'm just happy to win a premiership, and best and fairest tops it off.
Got a bit of time off, what are you doing from now?
I head over to Ireland on Tuesday with Nigel and Rennie and Benny Hart, so we're looking forward to that, and then we meet up with the players on the footy trip in South Africa, and also looking forward to that.
And on to 99. Mark, we're so proud to have you as our club champion. Please thank Mark Ricciuto, the 1998 Crows Club Champion. And one final thank you, Mark.
I didn't thank my parents and all the friends back at Wakery, so hopefully they're having a good night tonight back there.
Good on you, Mark. Well done. And that just about wraps it up from the Adelaide Convention Centre, the Football Park Convention Centre. Thank you very much for your company tonight, and on to 1999 for the Adelaide Crows. Good night. Thanks for watching.